After an acute illness, the physicians, the team, the medical team, the nurses, the respiratory therapists, everybody on that interdisciplinary team is trying to correct that initial injury or illness, whatever it is. These people usually are immobilized for a period of time. And so from that immobilization, the muscles get really, really impacted. And they start to atrophy, they lose their size, and they also lose their strength. As physical therapists, when we're able to start getting them up, they're just not able to do simple tasks. They need help to roll. They need help to get out of bed. One thing that I'm really big on is early mobility and how we can get these people up sooner. What are we doing as a team, not just physical therapists, but as a unit? How can we advocate and promote and get these people moving so that their impairments are not as bad when they go home? Muscle power is the combination of force and speed. So it takes into account how fast you're doing the task. For example, getting out of the chair takes muscle power to do it quickly and to stand up. Patients in critical illness, a lot of times I hear them say, "I can do it, I just can't do it fast enough." And so that's what I'm really talking about, is helping them regain that velocity of movement, that muscle power, to start to make their lives a little easier. And so I'd like to see, on a basic science level, is that really occurring? Are those fibers that are designed to do muscle power, are they more impacted? So the scholarship comes from the Foundation of Physical Therapy. It will allow a number of different things. A lot of our patients come from rural areas, and so they may not be able to travel back to Lexington after the ICU stay. And so we can give them funds that help them travel to get to us, and so we can follow up. It'll also allow me to disseminate my research, go to a conference and say, this is what we're finding. And it pays for a lot of other things that I wouldn't necessarily have if I didn't have the scholarship. So it makes the research doable, so to speak. I really have great mentors. I can't thank them enough. I'm really fortunate to have them, especially my co-chairs, my sponsors, Dr. DuPont-Verstegen and Dr. Morris. Research and PhD is a tough road, but there are other things that are important as well. And so keeping a balance in your life, whether it's maintaining some of the hobbies that I enjoy or spending time with family, I'm preparing for twins. So a lot's changing, but I think it goes back to balance. How I stay motivated is that drive to work with the patients that we have. It is kind of a hot button topic right now, ICU research, where our culture is aging. We have more and more elderly. They have issues that are going on health-wise, and we're seeing more admissions to the ICU, and so I know that I can have a great impact, especially in our physical therapy approach and our treatment.